الله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وبسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. أما بعد. In the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful, truly and verily all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and we seek only His help and His forgiveness. We also seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from evil of our nafs. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran that the nafs is inclined to do so except by the mercy of Allah. And we seek this mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obeying the Quran, and obeying the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, obeying the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We also seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the sayyati a'malina, those actions and those deeds that are not sanctioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, and those actions and deeds that are not sanctioned by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Sunnah. Those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills to be guided to Islam, which is total submission to the will and commandment of Allah, no one can lead them astray. And those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills to be led off the Sirat al-Mustaqim, which is the straight path, which is the path of Islam, guided by the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, no one can guide. We bear witness that there is no God but Allah, the one God who has no partners. And we bear witness that Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his slave and his messenger. Amma ba'd. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a hadith that verily the best speech, the best hadith, is the speech of Allah, meaning the Quran. And the best guidance, the best example, is the example of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, meaning the Sunnah. And the worst of all matters pertaining to this deed are those things that are innovated by the people. For all innovation leads to bid'ah, all bid'ah leads to dalala, which is going up the Sirat al-Mustaqim, and all dalala is in the nar, which is the fire. And alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Allah blessed us with Islam and blessed us with the opportunity we have saved from that nar. So we say, Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar, ya Allah. Ameen. We say, Lord, give us good in this life, the hasana of this dunya. And we ask Him to give us good in the next life, the hasana of the akhirah, and save us from the punishment of the fire, ya Allah. Ameen. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, we're blessed with another day of Yawm al-Jum'ah. And as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that this is a day of maghfirah. Because if we partake in certain things on this day, then alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, we have the opportunity of being forgiven of 10 days of forgiveness. 10 days of forgiveness. If we follow certain prerequisites, we do certain things, we make the ghusl like we're supposed to, we wear the best of clothes, we put on oil, we use miswak, we clip our nails, we come to the masjid early before the khatib says assalamu alaikum, we make tayyatul masjid, we sit quietly and in khasha'ah, waiting for the khutbah, and during the khutbah we don't say any words, and during the salat we're in khasha'ah and we're in ikhlas, and we only think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the salat. So alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, we have that opportunity. So surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. And as we talked about last week, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that when you make a sincere tawbah, when you make a sincere repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said He will change your sayyat into a hasana. Now we must remember that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said through the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that He will forgive all your sins from this Friday, the previous Friday, and 10 days, this is including the sayyat. These are the minor sins, not the kabair. The kabair are the major sins, those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala threatens with His wrath, He threatens with His la'na, His curse, those things that He threatens with the hellfire. These are the things that you must make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for. You must specifically quote these things and state these things to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you make this sincere tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So again, the sayyat or the minor sins that you're forgiven for the 10 days or the minor sins. I was asked about the kabair or the major sin of zina. So inshallah, this is a dhikr inshallah. Again, Rasulullah, excuse me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran and remind, for verily the reminder, it benefits the mu'mineen. With regards to the subject matter of zina, what is fornication and what is adultery? Inshallah, just give it a little clarity as to the definition of zina. Those who are not married, this is fornication. Those that are married, this is called adultery. In Islam, you have to have 4 witnesses in order to charge somebody with the charge of zina. When we say 4 witnesses, it's not that you see somebody coming out the motel room, or you see somebody talking to somebody, or texting or whatnot, but you must see the penetration. All 4 people must see the penetration. As Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, did you dip the bucket in the well? Meaning you dip the bucket in the well, meaning penetration. This is zina. There was a man who came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he wished to receive the hudud from Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with regards to being with a woman. And he said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I was with the woman and I want to receive my hudud. He said, I did everything with her except, you know, penetrate. He said, well, did you dip the bucket in the well? He said, no, I didn't dip the bucket in the well. He said, well, go make 2 rakats. He said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is this just for me or anybody else who incurs or goes through the same type of fitna or this type of sayyat? He said, this is for anybody who incurs this same type of fitna or this type of sayyat. So anything other than the penetration is not zina. This is something else. And as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us the hadith and gave us the example that you make 2 rakats. For Allah says in the Quran that when you do a certain sin, when you do a sayyat, you do some type of ithm, that you follow it up with some type of good action. So he gave the example of the 2 rakats. Okay? So this is just the clarity with regards to the zina. You cannot accuse somebody of zina. Okay? Allah said if you accuse somebody of zina, okay, which is adultery or fornication, and you don't have 4 witnesses, meaning yourself and 3 other people, then you can be guilty of slander, and the hudud for slandering is 80 lashes. The only thing that can make someone guilty of zina, if there's 4 witnesses, they witness the penetration, the bucket entering the well, they must all see it. Not somebody telling you, but they all must see it, or the person himself, he tells on himself 4 times. He bears witness to himself 4 times, as we've seen in the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as well in the time of Umar radiallahu anhu. There's also something in Islam that's called li'an. Okay, there's also something in Islam that's called the li'an, or causing upon the curse of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for the liar. This is between a husband and a wife. Or if the husband accuses wife of adultery, or the wife she accuses her husband of adultery, it's called a li'an. When you have a sit down, you call, you bear witness 4 times that you're speaking the truth and that the other person is a liar. And on the 5th time, you incur the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you're lying. Now, this is something that's very serious in Islam. So there is another way to accuse somebody. This is only between a husband and a wife, and this is called a li'an. So again, this is just a dhikr, right? So we have a better understanding. We cannot accuse people of certain things in Islam. You must have 4 witnesses. You cannot accuse somebody of zina. You cannot accuse somebody of fornication or adultery unless you got 4 other witnesses. If you do not have 4 other witnesses, then you could be guilty of namima, which is slander, and you can receive the 80 lashes in Islam. So that's just a dhikr. We talked last week about the Tawheed al-Asma wa Sifat, which is the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, inshallah, today we'll talk about a couple more of the attributes of Allah, because we're still staying or sticking to the script of Tawheed. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he taught Tawheed for 13 years. Out of the 23 years, he taught Tawheed for 13 years. So this was something that was very important. We need to, inshallah, go back to Tawheed and go back to the foundations. Go back to our fundamentals, so inshallah we can start getting it right. Sometimes you got to go back to the basics. And the basis is Tawheed. Okay? Also, another reminder, being that this is Jummah, please increase your salah upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For bringing the salah upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he hears the salah on Friday that is given to you. So inshallah, we make salah upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For surely with the salah upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we get raised in 10 degrees of darajat, we get 10 degrees of barakat, and we get 10 of our sayyat removed from our plate, inshallah. Again, speaking about Tawheed al-Asma wa Sifat, if we read from Ayatul Kursi, the first verse or the first phrase of Ayatul Kursi, الله سيس أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. الحي القيوم. These are two of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Hayyu Al-Qayyum. He is the one that gives life, and He is the one that sustains. He is the one that gives life. So therefore, us even being in existence, this is by the decree and the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He also is the one who sustains. Again, this is all still part of Tawheed. Tawheed al-Uluhiyya, Tawheed al-Rububiyya. When we make the Fatiha, or when we do the Fatiha, also in the Fatiha, we say, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Only you, Ya Allah, do we worship. Only you, Ya Allah, do we seek help and forgiveness. All of these things is connected. So being that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the giver of life, and being that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the sustainer of all of the things that we have, then surely we should be of those who are grateful to Him and do what He commands us to do. When you have a proper understanding of Tawheed, your feet will be firmly rooted. When you have a proper understanding of Tawheed, you remove all the illusions and all the doubts. When you have a proper understanding of Tawheed, you will no longer be discombobulated as to what is your purpose in life. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran that verily He created jinn and men liya'budun. Except that you worship Him. The only reason why we're here is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you step upon the track, or you step upon the journey of Tawheed, then you must understand that, man, you will obtain or receive opposition. Tawheed is the opposite of shirk. Tawheed is the opposite of shirk. And it is the thing that is hated by Shaytan. We read in the Quran from chapter 6, Surah Al-An'am, verse 112, to give some light as to the reality as the war that goes on with those who advocate this deen of Tawheed. الله سيكس أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وكذلك جعلنا لكل نبي عدوا شياطين الإنس والجن يوهي بعضهم إلى بعد زخرف القول غرورا ولو شاء ربك ما فعلوه فذرهم وما يفترون. Allah says in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Again, when you step upon the realm, or you step upon the track, or the journey of Tawheed, as we say in the Quran, remember the Quran is a dua. The Quran is a dua. We say, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ. Guide us to the path of those who you have bestowed your ni'mah upon, Ya Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is the path of those who has bestowed his ni'mah upon? Allah says the Nabiyeen, the Siddiqeen, the Salihin and the Shuhada. So Allah states in the Quran, chapter 6, verse 112, Allah states, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. And so we have made and we have appointed for every prophet enemies. So we have made and appointed for every prophet enemies, shayateen, devil advocates among mankind and among jinn, inspiring one another. And the word that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses in this ayah is wahyi. He says they inspire and give some type of revelation to one another. And with adorned speech, meaning with some type of spit, some type of dictation. And also as it states in the tafsir that this is done through music. They ask Shaitan, how do you call the people to your millah? How do you call them to your deen? He said, I call them through music. And deception. And if your Lord had willed, they would not have done it. He allows it. So leave them alone with their fabrications. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in this ayah that the way of all the prophets, and again we say, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ. We're striving to be on the path of the prophets. We follow the way of the prophets. If you strive to follow the way of the prophets, then surely you will be like them. You will go through the things that they went through. You go through the trials and tribulations that they went through. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this ayat that for every Nabi, every prophet, He said, shayateen among jinn and among mankind, inspiring one another. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that the enemy of those who are striving to be in the Sirat al-Mustaqim, they may be from the jinn and they may be from mankind. It said they inspire one another with illusions and deceptions. They inspire one another with their speech. As with, again, like I said, in the tafsir said, it is done through the music. What is one of the main things that is the main propagator or the main thing that hypnotizes the people of today? It is through the music. It is through the music. And we have many hadith with regards to the music and it being haram. So let's not be in doubt as to that. And we'll talk about that another day. But according to this ayat, this is how Shaitan, he manipulates the people. And when you understand that, and you understand that the way of all the prophets is that there are shayateen that are sent against them. This is the way. Allah said he has made and appointed for the prophets shayateen. We're also told in Surah Al-A'raf, chapter 7, verse 27. Allah tells us, O mankind, fear Allah, and do not be deceived like your mother and your father, Adam, as they were kicked out of paradise, and Shaitan came to them. He said, he and his qabilahu, him and his soldiers, they see you from places where you cannot see them. They see you. So again, another ayah in the Quran that Allah tells us that Shaitan has soldiers. Whenever you step upon the Sirat al-Mustaqim, because Allah said that Shaitan will be on the Sirat al-Mustaqim. He won't be off the Sirat al-Mustaqim. Whenever you strive to do the right thing, the best beware Shaitan is coming. So he said, beware of Shaitan and his qabilahu, his soldiers. So the same way that Allah has those who stand firm in his deen, those who will put their life on the line for the deen, so the Shaitan and the shayateen. And he said, not just for mankind, but jinn too. And he said they have some type of correspondence. They have some type of communication between each other. Allah also said in the Quran that do you not see that they seek to get izzah, some type of power from the jinn. There's people that do this. They seek magic, right? Anytime that you do anything with fasha or munkar, or you do shirk, or you turn away from the will of Allah, you turn away from the dhikr of Allah, the shayateen is coming. He said he'll send the qareen. He said he'll send the jinn to be your close buddy, your close friend. And he said, although you will be misguided, you will think that you are guided. So we must be very careful. And we must also understand that we must also be on guard. That whenever you strive to build a Sirat al-Mustaqim, and that is the ultimate goal. That's what we ask Allah. Ihdinas Sirat al-Mustaqim. Ya Allah, guide us to the straight path. Guide us to that straight path, Ya Allah. And they ask, what is the Sirat al-Mustaqim? The Sirat al-Mustaqim is the path of Islam. What is it guided by? It's guided by the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What's on the sides of it? He said there are shayateen. They'll try to get you off the Sirat al-Mustaqim, calling you to this and calling you to that. So again, make me understand that Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, whenever you strive to be on Sirat al-Mustaqim, the shayateen is coming. There's a hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this is in the book of Kitab al-Tawheed by Ibn Wahab. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, those who please Allah at the displeasure of man, Allah will be pleased with them, and he will make the people pleased with him. But those who displease Allah at the pleasure of man, Allah will be displeased with them and make the people displeased with him. So the thing is, if you strive to please Allah, subhanAllah, you win both ways. Although you will be going through trials and tribulations, although you'll be hit with fitness, Allah subhanAllah said that in the long run, he will be pleased with you and it will make the people pleased with you. He'll make them respect you, right? But again, this is the way, this is the millah of those who strive to be the mu'mineen. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that those who are the most tested are the prophets. Then those who have less faith in them, then less faith in them. So the more faith, the more iman that you have, the surer you will be tested. But those who please man, right, because of the fitness, because of the trials and tribulations, because of the peer pressure, because you don't want to seem like the oddball, because you don't want to go against the norm, Allah will say that he will be displeased with you, and in the long run, he'll make the people displeased with you. So guess what? You lose out both ways. So the best way to do, or the best thing to do, is to please Allah and strive for the akhirah. Strive for that which is in the hereafter. Although we can't see it, but this is part of belief in the game. Although we don't know what's in store, but we have to keep on pushing. We have to put our trust in Allah. We have to mutawakkilin. We don't know. As one of the brothers said, that this deen is not a sprint. This deen is a marathon. You can't just jump off the track because it gets too hard. How are you going to know if you're ever going to make it? You keep jumping off the track. You keep stopping, right? You keep giving up, throwing your hands up because it gets too hard. But surely, as Allah said in the Quran, chapter 29, verse 1 through 3, he said, what? Just because you said you believe, do you not think that you will not be tested?
Surely those before you got tested, and they got tested with things way more worse than we did. There was a time with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a man who was put in the ground, and the dirt all around him, and a saw was put on his head, and he was sawed in half. Can we go through that? Can we withstand that? Is any of that happening to us while we sit here eating our potlava and chai and eating lamb and rice and whatnot? Surely we're not going through any of those trials and tribulations, so surely we should be able to shakirin that Allah bless us with some of His rahmah here in this society that we live in, inshallah. Again, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, those who please Allah at the displeasure of man, Allah sallallahu will be pleased with you. And surely that's what we want. We want the pleasure of Allah. And He said He will make the people pleased with you. Keep pushing. Keep striving. It don't matter what nobody thinks. For surely Allah said that the believers, they do not fear the blame of the blamers. They don't care about the naysayers. They don't care about those who point fingers. As we say, you point the finger, notice the three point back at you. They keep on pushing. They keep on striving. And then Allah SWT said that He will make them pleased with you. He'll make them respect you. But you got to keep on pushing. The other part of the hadith, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, but if you displease Allah for the law at the pleasure of man, Allah for the law will be displeased with you, and surely we don't want that. And He said He'll make the people displeased with you as well, so therefore you lose both ways. May we seek refuge in Allah for the law from that, inshallah. Ameen. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan rajeem, wa bismillah ar-rahim, and alhamdulillah, wa ashadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashadu anna Muhammad rasulullah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Again, Allah SWT blesses with this gift of Islam. And surely there is no type of recompense that we can pay back Allah SWT for this beautiful gift of Islam. Allah SWT said that verily if He wishes to guide someone, it is He, Allah SWT, that will open one's heart to Islam. Right? We say this is Maliki Yawm al-Din. Allah SWT is Maliki Yawm al-Din. He is the King and the authority of the Deen. The day that we pay back our debt to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then surely because He has guided us to Islam, we must pay back and show our respect, show our thankfulness, show our gratitude by our actions and our obedience. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Again, whenever you're on the Sirat al-Mustaqeem, whenever you follow this Deen or you try to advocate Tawheed, or whatever it is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with, if you follow the way of the prophets, or you do the way of the prophets, or you become a da'i, as the scholars say, because the da'i are the ones that take on the way or the ways of the prophets, because they have the knowledge that is revealed to them through the prophets. If you strive to be a da'i, you strive to advocate tawheed, then get ready. Lace your boots. Get ready. Stand on your toes. Because here comes the shayateen. Not just from the jinn, but from mankind as well. And it says that they have some type of connection and some type of correspondence between the two. So therefore, you better believe in the game. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ وَلَرَيْبَ فِيهُ دَلَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. Those who believe in the unseen, you've got to believe it. If you don't believe it, then you're already going to lose. You better understand and get knowledge. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, those who strive to obtain knowledge, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the path to paradise easy. They asked him, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what is knowledge? He said, knowledge is knowledge of Allah wa Rasuluhu. Knowledge of the Quran and knowledge of the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One more hadith, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, those who strive for the akhirah, Allah sallallahu will give them the akhirah and the dunya. Those who strive for the akhirah, not even asking for the dunya. You strive for the akhirah, pleasing Allah sallallahu with your sincere ibadah, your sincere obedience to Allah sallallahu. He said He'll give you the akhirah and the dunya without even asking for it. But those who strive for the dunya, He might give you this dunya, but you won't get no akhirah. Strive for the akhirah. Strive for that which is best, inshallah. Any good that I said today, again, this is just a nasiha. This is just a reminder. And Allah SWT says that remind, for verily the reminder benefits the mu'mineen. And we strive to be the mu'mineen. Ashab and yameen. Those who are the people or the companions of the right. Those who get their book in the right hand. Those who be saved from a da'wah nar with da'wah jaheen. Inshallah, ameen. Again, this is just a reminder. For verily the reminder benefits the mu'mineen. Any good that I said today is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the names of Allah, Al-Aleem. All knowledge comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Anything that I say misconstrued or incorrect from my own knowledge or from shaitan, I say I will be with Allah, even shaitan.